Hello everyone. Welcome to the playlist of sensors and transducers. In this video, I'll be discussing about Hall effect transducers. In order to get my previous video, please click on the I button. Moving on to the technical discussion on Hall effect transducers. Let us understand what do you mean by Hall effect transducer. Actually, Hall effect transducers will operate based on the principle of Hall effect. And we should require one Hall effect element. We need to understand what is the peculiarity of Hall effect, how it occurs. Actually, main purpose of measuring or main purpose of using Hall effect transducer is to measure the magnetic field. Thereby, you can able to measure the movement of any physical object. You can able to measure the power, current, etc. So these are the speciality of Hall effect transducers. Let us understand the definition of Hall effect transducer. The Hall effect element is a type of transducer used for measuring the magnetic field by converting into an EMF. You can measure the magnetic field in terms of an EMF. The direct measurement of magnetic field is not possible. There is no other way to measure the magnetic field directly. So you are measuring the magnetic field in terms of electromotive force, EMF. For that purpose, we are going to use Hall effect transducer. So that is the main purpose of using Hall effect transducer. Thereby, you can able to measure other quantities also. Okay. The transducer converts the magnetic field into electrical quantity, which is easily measured by either analog or digital meters. What I'm trying to speak, the magnetic field that will be measured in terms of EMF, that particular EMF can be measured with the help of any digital voltmeter or analog voltmeters. So that is the thing which I would like to inform you. So let us continue the discussion regarding the Hall effect transducer. So these are the introduction part. How does Hall effect transducer operate? First of all, we have to familiar the diagram given here. And we are having a Hall element. It is also known as Hall strip. You can able to observe very clearly. And you can able to see different sections like 1, 2, then 3, 4. And T is the thickness of the material. That means thickness of the element. First of all, we are supposed to provide a supply to the Hall element, current supply to the Hall element. For that purpose, we are having a battery source, E. We are having a battery source. Then to limit the current, we are having current limiting resistor. Then to measure the current, we are having one ammeter. Okay. So whenever I am going to provide the battery over here, there will be a supply. Okay, there will be a continuous current that will be starting from 1 to 2. See, current will be passing from 1 and it will be directly passing in this way. And finally, it has come back to the negative end of the battery side. So there is a continuous current which we have provided already. Second point I would like to say, there is a magnetic field, transverse magnetic field that we are going to pass in another end. In another end, we are going to pass the transverse magnetic field. If you look at the direction of current and magnetic field, let me call magnetic field as phi. Okay, magnetic field is nothing but it's a group of magnetic lines of force, or you can call flux. Okay, flux, the lot of flux that will be passing from one end. So if I look at the diagram, then we can say that current and the flux, that means magnetic field, both are perpendicular. It is very clear. Okay, the thing is, we are using the Hall strip. There is a current. Then there is a transverse magnetic field. With respect to the transverse magnetic field, what is going to happen means the EMF will be generating at the end between 2 and 3. There will be, sorry, at the end of 3 and 4. There will be an EMF induced in between 3 and 4. You can able to see another side, 3 and 4. See, current will be passing in between 1 and 2. And you are passing a transverse magnetic field which is perpendicular to the current. Now, what observation you can make? You can able to get the EMF, okay, at the end 3 and 4. So that is very clear. So the magnetic field that will be generated, the EMF. Okay, so magnetic field that can be measured in terms of EMF. How much amount of magnetic field that has been generated over here, that will be measured in terms of voltage, or you can call EMF. That can be measured with the help of voltmeter. So the current supply will be through lead 1 and 2, which is very clear. And the output is obtained in across 3 and 4. That is also very clear. So 3 and 4 are same potential and no field is applied across the strip. That is very true. So when the magnetic field is applied to the strip, so we are applying the transverse magnetic field, the output voltage developed across the lead 3 that will be observing very clearly over here. The developed voltage is directly proportional to the strength of material. So this is the way how Hall effect transducer operate. We require a Hall strip and we require a current supply. We have to provide the continuous current. Then we need to maintain another terminal to measure the Hall voltage in parallel to the passage of magnetic lines of force, or you can call magnetic flux. Okay. So this is regarding Hall effect transducers. So you have to familiar these components and you can directly explain. Okay. Let me continue the discussion. How does it operate? I have written the explanation for you. See, the principle of Hall effect transducer is that if the current carrying strip of the conductor is placed at a transverse magnetic field, that means both are perpendicular, then EMF develop on the edge of the conductor. This is applicable only for the Hall element is present over there. The magnitude of developed voltage depending on the flux density. What is flux density? Flux density is nothing but the flux per unit area, phi divided by A. It is expressed in terms of Weber per meter square. Okay, flux density. We are going to measure in terms of flux density. The magnitude of the developed voltage, that means EH. EH will be directly depending on the flux density, and this property of a conductor is called Hall effect. The Hall effect element is mainly used for magnetic measurement. You can able to measure the intensity of magnetic field and the sensing current. These are the specialty of the Hall effect element and the Hall effect transducer. Okay, this is the way how Hall effect transducer operates. Let us calculate how much voltage is induced over here. So we are providing a current over here. Then there is a transverse magnetic field. With respect to the intensity of transverse magnetic field, the Hall voltage will be generated across 3 and 4. Let us calculate how much Hall voltage will be generated across 3 and 4. By using this formula, KH is equal to EH is equal to KH into I into B divided by T. What is T? T is nothing but thickness of the material, and B is known as flux density. It is Weber per meter square, or you can call Tesla. I is the total magnitude of current which is flowing in between 1 and 2. And KH is known as Hall coefficient. So this is the unit of Hall coefficient. You can able to identify the unit of Hall coefficient. Okay. So this is important relation regarding Hall effect transducer. So we can able to say that the EMF which is induced in between terminal 3 and 4, that is directly proportional to the flux density B. It is very clearly explained from this particular equation. This equation is very important, and let us solve the numerical example also. Now let us list what are the applications of Hall effect transducer. The first application, measurement of displacement. Okay, our ultimate goal is to measure displacement over here. Displacement, okay, external mechanical body will be connected directly over here. So we need to measure how much displacement happened for the mechanical object. So that particular mechanical object that will be directly connected to ferromagnetic plate. Okay, now let us see, this is your Hall effect element and we are having a structural member. That means there is a permanent magnetic gap is placed over. There is a permanent magnetic gap that is placed over there. Okay, you already know that the Hall voltage that is directly proportional to magnetic field. You can write magnetic flux density. Yes, we have familiar. Whenever the motion, whenever the movement is happening from the mechanical object, definitely there is a distortion in the magnetic field. Whenever the magnetic field getting distorted, the Hall voltage is getting reduced. So if there are some distortion in the magnetic flux density, obviously the EMF, which is generated across the another terminal of the Hall effect element, that is getting reduced. Thus, we will identify that if the displacement is more, there is a distortion, more amount of distortion happens. With respect to the distortion, what is going to happen? The Hall voltage is getting varied. This is the way how you can able to measure the displacement. So I have written the explanation over here. The Hall effect element measures the displacement of structural element. The Hall effect transducer placed between the poles of the permanent magnet. It is very clear. Okay, so it creates the transverse magnetic field. The magnetic field strength across the Hall element changes by changing the position of the ferromagnetic field. So this identify the changes in position for a magnetic plate. Okay, according to that, all EMF will be varied. You can able to measure the changes in displacement in terms of Hall EMF, Hall effect EMF. You can call EH. Thus, you can able to measure the displacement very easily. Let us discuss how to measure the magnetic field. Another application to measure the magnetic field. You can able to measure the magnetic field by using Hall effect transducer. Okay. So we have to pass the magnetic field in this particular area. Okay, this is the area where you are going to pass the magnetic field. Definitely, we need to provide a suitable supply. Suitable supply need to be provided. Okay. Now, depends on the intensity of the magnetic field, the Hall EMF will be getting varied. So that means the flux density, we can call flux density, that is directly proportional to Hall voltage. So what is actually flux density? Flux per unit area, correct? No, phi by L, that is directly proportional to Hall EMF. So as the flux increases, obviously Hall voltage will be getting increased. Okay, so this is the way how you can able to measure the magnetic field by using Hall effect transducer. For making the Hall effect element, it is better to go for gallium arsenate, indium phosphide, germanium, etc. These are the popular material which is used to measure, which is used to construct Hall effect element. Okay, so by using the setup, I can able to measure the intensity of magnetic field very easily in terms of Hall voltage, EH. I would like to continue the discussion on application of Hall effect transducer. We can able to measure the current. Okay, you know that we have a Hall effect transducer, and both the current and magnetic field both are perpendicular in case of the Hall effect transducer. So we have the magnetic concentrator that produce the constant flux, and this is your current. Okay, this is a current carrying conductor. This is your current carrying conductor. And this will be the Hall element. You can able to say that Hall element. This particular segment is Hall element. And here you are going to measure the Hall voltage across the terminals of the Hall element. Okay. Anyway, here magnetic field is constant. Now, you are going to pass the high value of current. You are passing the current. Okay. You are going to pass the current. With respect to intensity of the current, what is going to happen? Hall voltage will be getting varied. So the current that is directly proportional to the Hall voltage. As the current increases, what is going to happen? As the current increases, the Hall voltage is getting increased. So both are directly proportional. Therefore, if you are going to pass high value of current, the Hall EMF also getting increased. So you can measure the current in terms of Hall voltage, because you must have seen the equation. You must have familiar the equation that the total Hall voltage can be computed by the given equation. I'll be showing you the equation once again. EH is equal to KH IB divided by T. So EH is directly proportional to current. Okay, that point you have to recall. This is actually working based on principle of Biot-Savart law. Okay, you can recall the principle of Biot-Savart law. According to that, you can able to measure the current in terms of Hall voltage. So this is the way how you can able to measure the current. Now I would like to discuss about power, how to measure the power. Okay, so whenever you want to measure the power, the Hall element is required here, and we have to pass the transverse magnetic field, and the conductor, the current should be continuously passed to the conductor. The Hall effect transducer is used for measuring the power of the conductor. Okay, that means there must be a flow of continuous flow of the current to the conductor. So current applied to the conductor which develop a magnetic field. So intensity of the field depending on the current, and the magnetic field induces the voltage across the strip. That means the whole power which will be passing through the conductor, that will be directly proportional to Hall EMF. The total power can be measured in terms of Hall voltage. As the power increases, obviously Hall voltage is also very much high. Both are directly proportional. Okay, so this is the way how you can able to measure the power of a given element. Okay, power can be measured with the help of the Hall element. So both are directly proportional. Power directly proportional to Hall voltage. Okay. So we have, so far we have studied about the applications to measure the displacement, then magnetic field, measurement of current and power. Now let us discuss what are the major pros and cons of Hall effect transducer. First in the foremost, Hall effect element gives continuous electrical signal in direct response to the magnetic field. That is very true. And the space requirement is very less and a high speed of operation, more than 100 kilohertz. It operates with the stationary unit. There is no much more moving part. It is a true solid state. There won't be no wear and tear because there is no moving part. High repeatable operation. You can do the operation as many times as you can. Nothing will happen if you're operating the same principle many times. Okay, same operation many times. Okay, it is reliable. What are the major drawbacks of Hall effect transducer? The first problem is some of the Hall effect element that will be depending on temperature, sensitive to temperature. Okay, so that is another problem. Calibration is somewhat tedious procedure. Calibration for extending the range is somewhat difficult. And regarding the distance, for the measurement of distance or displacement, it is not capable for measuring the current flow at a distance above 10 centimeter. That is another issue. And since the Hall effect utilizes magnetic field for measurement, the stray magnetic field may cause inaccurate reading. Okay, because the magnetic field variation causes the wrong reading, because EH will be varied, depends on the transverse magnetic field. If the magnetic field changes because of stray magnetic field, definitely the Hall voltage will be getting varied. So that may lead to error. And the accuracy is poor compared to other type of measurement, accuracy is poor here. So these are the major cons of Hall effect transducer. Okay. I have referred the following textbook to collect the information. Finally, thank you very much for watching this video.